The last two slides of this chapter, we talk about the ventilation. So every time you breathe, your tidal volume is about 500 mL. But not all 500 mL is going to reach your alveoli. The reason is you have the anatomical dead space. Your airway, your air, those pipes, they take space. And it's impossible to get rid of them. Some air going to stay in your airway. And we won't be able to really measure your anatomically dead space. We have to estimate, and the estimation is about, if you weigh 1 pound, it's about 1 mL. So physiology man is about 154 pounds, and we use 150, so his dead space is about 150 mL. So every time you breathe, you have 500 mils move into your lung, but eventually only you take 500, subtract out 150, only 350 mils fresh air reach your alveoli. But the next time you breathe, those 150 will move in as well. But every time you breathe, you actually have 350 reach your alveoli. And when we calculate the, why is this important? When we calculate the breathing rate, ventilation rate, and pulmonary ventilation rate and alveoli ventilation rate, we found they're different. If you only calculate the pulmonary ventilation rate, we use the tidal volume, which is 500 mL, multiply your breathing rate about 12 times per minute. But if I ask you the alveoli ventilation rate, how much air really reaches the alveoli, you have to take 500, subtract out 150, which is the air really reaches the alveoli, and multiply your breathing rate, multiply 12 times per minute, and the alveoli ventilations will be smaller than the number will be smaller than your pulmonary ventilation. And also, this explains why your lung is a stable, very stable environment, even though you're breathing all the time. In your body want to have a stable environment. Everything want to be just right. And even including your lung environment. And every time you breathe, you bring in new oxygen, you breathe out, you get CO2 out. And your lung environment looks like it constantly change. But it turns out it's not, it's relatively stable. And the reason is when you breathe, every time you breathe, only 350 mils of fresh air gonna reach your alveoli. And your lung volume, the functional residual volume, is about 1200 mil. So when you take this number divided by this, you found it's like every time you just change about 10% of the air. So the other 90% are pretty, still remain the same. So your lung environment, even though you're breathing all the time, your lung environment still relatively stable. And the last slides, these slides talk about the local control. This is, the concept is very similar to what we talk about in the local control of the blood flow. The blood will flow to the area require more oxygen. We talk about that in the cardiovascular system. And they use the vasodilator when the local tissue produce more metabolized molecules like the pH, like the nitric oxide and lactic acid. They're able to cause the vasodilation of the arterial and make the blood go to the tissue then metabolize more. Similar concept here. And in the lung, you have millions of alveoli. Even though in a normal situation, in a healthy situation, not all alveoli expand equally. So some alveoli are going to have more oxygen than the other. And you don't want to have the blood go to those alveoli with low oxygen, high CO2, because you waste those blood. You want the blood to go to the alveoli with fresh air. And this need to be local control. You could not use global control, because every seconds you breathe, the environment change. Could be this alveoli, could be this one, could be the next one. So it need to be local control. It turned out the oxygen level, they are very sensitive to the PO2 level, the pulmonary arteries. They are very sensitive to the PO2. And when the blood flow there, those low PO2 will cause the constriction of the blood vessel. So it turned out this one, because of the low PO2, will cause the constriction, and when you constrict, the blood automatically go to here, because the blood find the blood vessel to go with the lowest resistance. The blood automatically go to here, and that's the one with high PO2 level. So with this local control, you are able to optimize the efficiency of the oxygen load from the lung into the blood. Okay, let's stop here.